Hello friends, do you know how a solar panel is made in factory and how does it work? Probably you would not know. So friends, in this video, I will show you how solar panels are made in factory. So main ingredients that makes them work is silicon or sand, which comes from rocks found in a quarry like this. The first stage is to get the silicon out of the rocks, and that is done in this enormous furnace temperature reach well over 2000 degrees Celsius. Solar panels are made using thin slices of silicon which have two unique layers. In them, these are created using two chemical processes, which affect the silicon at different times during production. This time for stage 1. This is where the first chemical is added. It will help make the silicon more conductive. After burn this silicon solid, the furnace is opened and the silicon blocks emerges. Now these blocks be cut down to size. Cutting solid crystal is not like cutting a butter. It can be very dangerous, so a protective shield is raised to keep workers safe. Now individual panels size columns ready for the next stage. This basic round crystal known as a ingot is now cut into a rectangular shape. This is done for purely practical reasons. Later on, square shaped solar cells can be installed much more effectively on the surface of a solar module. The ingots are cut into millimeter thin slices using a very fine wire saw. The individual slices are called wafers. And from the basis of each solar cells, once the wafer have been cut, they are sent through a wash tunnel. This is because even the smallest piece of dust or dirt can compromise solar cells production. The wafer surface is now very flat, just like a mirror. Many rays of lights are reflected and can no longer be used to generate power. To prevent the reflection, the surface is attached and rough in a chemical. Now these cells transported a stamp that presses a silver alloy on the front of their cells. This creates the typical grid pattern. This silver coating sources that the power can be transported later on. The solar cells are now completely, they can generate and transfer power. But each cell has a different level of electrical conductivity in a series of testes. The cell's conductivity is evaluated and sorted following the test phase. The solar cells are assembled and the cells soldered together in such a way that the voltage accumulates in a process referred to as lamination. The cells are assembled behind a pane of glass. As a result, they are protected from the elements for more than 25 years. One solar module contains 16 cells. When a number of modules are connected to one another, a solar power plant is created, and power is generated from the sun and the sand. So now we are going to see how solar panels work. Well, they do it with the help of photovoltaic cells. It has two slices made of semiconducting materials, usually silicon. One slice has excess electrons called as negative side, and the other has a deficit of electrons called as positive side. Now the electrons from the negative side move to the positive side to fill in the holes. Due to this, near the junction, a negative charge develops on the positive side and a positive charge on the negative side. Thus, an electric field is generated from the negative to the positive side. However, after a while, the movement of electrons is opposed due to the negative charges on the positive side. Now the sunlight consists of photons, elementary particles just like electrons having kinetic energy. When the photon strike the semiconductor material, they release the electrons from their atoms. These free electrons, both of the established electric field, move to produce an electric current. So guys, you must have known how the solar panel finally works.